Are you terrified of adding data to your UICollectionView controller? Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and fear not, because in this video, we are going to use UICollectionView controller diffable data sources to sort all of your problems out. So subscribe to the channel, open up Xcode, and let's just dive in. So let's take a look at the data source part of our UICollectionView controller that Apple has introduced, and it's really amazing. In the previous video, I have talked about the layout, we have set up the collection view, and we have created our custom layout. So go ahead and take a look at that if you haven't already done so. We have some resources there, so yeah, make sure to check out that. Now in this video, we are finally going to make it all work together and create the data source. So make sure you are in the collectionViewController.swift file and just scroll a little bit up, and you can see that the first to do is add the data source and the data source snapshot type alias. We're going to use type aliases because it's much easier to type out code. Well, it's much easier to look at. So let's just add these two type aliases. And the first one is the data source. So type alias, and I will name this data source. And we are going to create, or we are going to use a UI collection view, a collection view. UI, not collection. It is a collection view controller, but it needs to be a data source. There we go. UI view. Diffable data source. This is what we want. So yeah, make sure you got that. And then add the section and add a contact. Now a section, we have already created these sections. So that's the section that we are going to use. So section, and the data that we are going to populate it with is the contact. So contact, there we go. Go ahead and take a look at the downloaded resources or maybe the previous video that explains all of this. Now, the next one, we want to create a type alias for our data source snapshots. So type alias, data source, let's have that with capital S, snapshot. Okay, and that will be an NS diffable data source snapshot. I know it's quite a lot, but yeah, we will get accustomed to that. So NS diffable data source snapshot. And again, we are going to use a section and a contact. Okay, so that's that. We are ready with the type aliases because we are going to use them in just a moment. So we don't have to type all of this out every time we use them. Next up, we need to create a data source and the snapshots. Well, basically, we are just going to kind of declare them. And they could be private because maybe we have some in some other places, data sources and snapshots. So data source, private var, sorry, private var data source. And that will be a data source that we have just set up as type alias. And that needs to be declared. So that's why I'm banging it out here. So again, private var, and we're just going to initialize the snapshot as is. So snapshot equals data source snapshot. There we go. And we are initializing it. Okay, so that's for the setup part. Now, if you just take a look at the configure collection view data source and just scroll a little bit down, you will see it's empty. So we need to populate that. And it's quite easy. Basically, we want to create, well, initialize the data source. So let's just type out data source. And as you can see, it needs to be alive, initialized, and that will be a simple data source. So that is where we are using this data source, so it's much easier. And we are going to use collection view with the cell provider and so on. So just choose this one. The collection view will be simply the collection view that we have declared. And the cell provider, let's just hit a return here. And as you can see, it returns UI collection view, an index path, and the context. So basically, we are getting back three things and we are using them, all of them, and it's really awesome. So collection view and index path, and let's see here, context. Now, what we want to change here is that this will not be a simple UI collection view cell. This will be a context cell. So context cell. There we go. Now let's dequeue our cell. So let cell equals collection view dequeue reusable cell with reuse identifier. And if you recall, that's in the context cell dot reuse identifier. And for index path, this is just a simple index path that we have here. And now we want to explicitly say as context cell. I believe this is not that unfamiliar for you. And finally, if you take a look at the context cell, there is a configure function there with the context that basically adds in the info that we have here, the context model, and displays it in the cell. So cell.configure with context, and we add in there context. Finally, we have to return our cell. Okay. Now that's that. Okay, we have configured our data source. What we still need to do, if you take a look at this create the dummy data, because we are going to do that with the dummy data first, we have this apply snapshot. So once we configure the data source, we need to take a look at the changes that we have, and the changes are that we add all of these dummy contacts to the snapshot and then apply them. And this apply snapshot is right down here. And finally, we are just going to write this, and hopefully we will have some data shown in the simulator. So we have created the snapshot. So snapshot equals data source snapshot. There we go. And now we want to append the section and the items, and then we apply that to the snapshot. We applied to the data source. Okay, so let's just type it out. It's much easier. So snapshot append sections. There we go. And again, this is an array, so we are going to add in here section.main snapshot append items. And again, this will be an array, but because contacts is an array, we have our contacts, and the contacts is right over here. We apply that with the snapshot. And finally, on the data source, we apply, and we are not going to listen for the completion for now. We have this snapshot, and maybe animating differences set to false. Okay, and that should do it. Let's just build and run and see all of our dummy data. I know it's been a long, long coding session, two videos long, but finally we will see some data, and it's kind of long, but once you get a hang of it, you have the advantages to build out all of these cool layouts. So what we do have here is the name contact zero, and then we created an example zero at gmail.com, and we are fetching that adorable avatar according to this email. So that's what you see here. Okay, how awesome is that? And of course, this is scrollable. If we just set it to, let's say, 20, let's just hit Command R again. You can see here is our email, and yeah, we are fetching all of those. How awesome is that? Okay, now finally, we want to check out once we tap on a cell, what do we have to do? And that's pretty straightforward. We just need to scroll a little bit up to the did select item. Yes, let's go up here. And as you can see here, we just want to grab the contact because now we have these identifiers, we don't have index paths, but there's a cool way to grab the contact from the index path that we have selected. And it will return an optional, so we want to guard, let unwrap it, let's say contact equals, and here you have our your data source, and it's pretty simple, item and data identifier for index path. There we go, and the index path, it's the index path that we get from the did select item add, and as let's just return here, and we just want to print out the contact. Okay, and that's how simple it is. You don't have to loop through an array, and just remove that W. So you don't have to remove, you don't have to move through the array and grab the index path. You just grab it with item identifier for index path, and there we go. Let's just hit there, and let's see what we got here. Contact zero, name. Let me just do another one. Let's say contact three. There we go, contact three. We just tapped on it. You can navigate away. You do whatever you want with that contact. And finally, let's just make this a little much more fun. Let's not just create dummy data, but fetch items. And if we just scroll a little bit down, we see that it's fetching some data. And yeah, it's just getting the API URL and fetching all of that. And then once we get that JSON, we are applying the snapshot and it's the same. So adding, applying the snapshot to the data source. Okay. And again, this is just a list of contacts. And this API URL is, let's just scroll all the way up from the JSON placeholder.typecode.com. If you take a look at the first video, you will see where this is from. So let's just build again, and now using it with live data from the JSON placeholder. Okay, and there we go. We have 10 here. Let's just build and run again. There are some issues with downloading that image, but yeah, there we go. This is from that database. Now, this is how easy it is to create collection views the new way with diffable data sources. So now you know how you can populate your UI collection view controllers with data sources. How awesome is that? I want you to hit that notification bell because in my next video, I am going to talk about iOS application lifecycle in 2020. Now, while you wait for that, make sure to check out these two videos as well. I talk a lot about Swift UI, UI Kit, and Swift in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.